In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of shoulder girdle ligaments. But before I'm going to explain ligaments, let's do a kind of preview for today's video. I'm going to explain basic bony structures. This is clavicle. Yeah, clavicle. Easy, right? This is coracoid process. Coracoid process is part of scapula. And let's go to superior view. This is acromion. Acromion of scapula. Of course, this is humerus. These four parts are going to be important in this video. So let's go to a ligament attaches on coracoid process. The first ligament is this one. This ligament connects coracoid process and acromion. Coracoid process and acromion. So this is coracoacromial ligament. Coracoacromial ligament. Simple enough, right? This ligament is very important for shoulder impingement. Why? Because as you see, the space beneath this ligament is very, very narrow. By the way, this is a tendon of biceps brachii. It looks very, very tiny here, right? And there's also supraspinatus here. Supraspinatus is one of rotator cuff muscles, right? And there are many, many tissues here, and this space is very narrow. So if this coracoacromial ligament gets tight, it can affect this space and tissues around here. Very important place. So this is coracoacromial ligament. Let's move on to this part. This ligament is trapezoid ligament. Trapezoid ligament. And this is conoid ligament. Conoid ligament. With these two ligaments together, this is coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoclavicular ligament. This one is trapezoid ligament. This is conoid ligament. With these ligaments together, this is coracoclavicular ligament. Okay? Let's move on to the medial part. This is a little bit too thick. This is not that thick in reality. This is superior transverse scapular ligament. Oh my gosh, that's a long name. Superior transverse scapular ligament. This ligament is very, very important. Why? Because there's a hole here. This space here. In this space, one nerve penetrates this space. That is suprascapular nerve. Suprascapular nerve. Suprascapular nerve penetrates this hole from this way and comes, like, let's go to superior view. Run this way and comes to the posterior part of shoulder. So this nerve, suprascapular nerve, runs very uniquely. So what if this superior transverse scapular ligament gets tight or even calcified? This space will be diminished, and that can pinch this nerve, then it will create dysfunction of muscles or sensory system. Okay, so this ligament is very, very important. Let's review the ligaments from coracoid process. This is what? Coracoacromial ligament. Trapezoid ligament. Conoid ligament. These two guys together. This is coracoclavicular ligament. This is superior transverse scapular ligament. Oh my gosh. Coracoid process looks very important, right? Because many ligaments from coracoid process. Oh, by the way, one more ligament. This one. This ligament actually attaches on coracoid process. It originates from posterior part of coracoid process. You see that? You don't see that? But this ligament originates from around this area and attaches on humerus. So this is coracohumeral ligament. Coracohumeral ligament. This ligament is so important for shoulder mobility. If this ligament gets tight, it inhibits shoulder internal rotation. Shoulder internal rotation. I will say that again. If this coracohumeral ligament gets tight, This inhibits shoulder internal rotation. That sounds weird, doesn't it? Because this is on anterior part of shoulder. If anterior part of shoulder, let's say muscles or ligament, get tight, it will usually inhibit external rotation, right? Because when anterior part gets tight, it inhibits external rotation. However, this ligament inhibits internal rotation. So this is very interesting ligament. So many ligaments originate from coracoid process. Let's go to the superior view. What is this ligament? This ligament is on clavicle and acromion. So this is acromioclavicular ligament. This place is also important. This joint doesn't move a lot, but if somebody got clavicle fracture or shoulder dislocation or something happens here, this joint dysfunction can give huge impact for shoulder mobility. You know, shoulder joint is very important, of course, but ligaments on coracoid process or other joint are very important as well. So that's why I'm explaining ligaments around this area. Okay, and let's go to around shoulder joint. This is not very specific, but there are many ligaments. Like there's a superior glenohumeral ligament, middle glenohumeral ligament, inferior glenohumeral ligament, and there's a biceps running here. Actually, biceps kind of penetrates the tissues around here and attaches on scapula. So this complex is very important to understand mechanics of shoulder joint. See how important this place is? There are so many ligaments and connective tissue here. So in next part, I will use the pictures to explain each structure. So in this part, I will explain with pictures. This picture is on left shoulder. In first part, I was explaining right shoulder. So this is kind of the other side. Let's go to a coracoid process. This is coracoid process. This is clavicle, acromion, and this is humerus, right? At first part, I explained the ligaments from coracoid process, like this one. What was this one? This is coracoacromial ligament, right? Because it connects coracoid process and acromion. Coracoacromial ligament. This is trapezoid ligament. Trapezoid ligament. This is conoid ligament. These two ligaments together, this is coracoclavicular ligament. And let's go to this one, this tiny one. This is superior transverse scapular ligament. And what kind of nerve does pass here? Suprascapular nerve. This is very important for muscle and for the sensation. Easy, right? Let's go to this part. I change the color. Let's say there is a superior glenohumeral ligament, middle glenohumeral ligament, inferior glenohumeral ligament. This picture doesn't show the name, but there's a ligament here. And what is this one? What is this one? This one connects coracoid process and humerus. So this is coracohumeral ligament. Coracohumeral ligament. This ligament does not attach here. It attaches on back side of coracoid process. Remember, this ligament inhibits internal rotation of shoulder joint. This is very important. By the way, this is the tendon of biceps brachii. Biceps brachii penetrates connective tissue, then attaches on the scapula. See, this place is very, very important. Now, one more ligament. This part, this ligament connects acromion and clavicle. So this is acromioclavicular ligament. Oh my gosh, there are so many ligaments and connective tissue around the shoulder joint and this area. I will use another pictures to explain the anatomy. So this picture looks more like a three-dimensional structure. Coracoid process, humerus, and clavicle acromion, right? Coraco acromial ligament, and you see a trapezoid ligament, conoid ligament, superior, transverse, scapular ligament, and what is this? This one is coraco humeral ligament, and this is a joint capsule of the shoulder joint. There's superior glenohumeral ligament, middle glenohumeral ligament, and inferior glenohumeral ligament. Understanding the connective tissue around shoulder joint will help your understanding anatomy and clinical experience. I know anatomy is very hard at first time, but as you keep studying, it will help you in some day. So please do not give up studying anatomy. It's very fantastic to study. So this is today's video. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.